What's up, everybody? Homie Chewy Martinez, and we are on our way to Las Vegas, Nevada for the 2019 Latin Billboard Awards. I am excited. I am in my 2020 Kia Soul, and we need some road tripping music. Thank you, Kia, for having that Bluetooth technology on deck. Let's do it. Actually pick up some homies. We're gonna cruise the strip, Latin Billboards. We are here, come on. So here we are for the Latin Billboards, and I'm here with some badass DJs. And how did y'all get involved with Kia, man?
Wanna answer that, Eric?
Ooh, you go first.
Kia.
First of all, Kia, we wanna thank them for coming together.
Absolutely.
You know, and putting the Latino movement at a different level. We're helping us, you know, helping us out.
Hey.
You know, they done stuff now with the program that they're doing, you know what I mean, to show the world with DJs like us, especially the DJs
right.
like us, that we got to this level. And sometimes, you know, not that people don't appreciate it, you know, but we got to the level, we worked so hard to get here, and with Kia and their help, you know, we're gonna take it to the next level.
But yo, if there is anybody watching this, man, especially the youth, especially the brown youth, Latino youth,
right.
what would you tell them, man? What was that advice, that one piece of advice you would give them is if they want to get into the DJing, the music, this industry, what would that be?
I mean, first and foremost, they gotta love music. You know, just don't do it just for what, you know, the normal people see out there as the fame and the
right.
glitz and glams of everything. If you really love music and you have a passion for music and the art of DJing, then, you know, that's definitely step one.
Yeah.
And, you know, always have a passion for what you do, because if you have no passion and love behind it, it's just going to fail.
And how beautiful is it to be in this industry right now and being Latino? Like, it, you know, it's... To us in this car, I know for a fact, it's always been a cool thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? But is our music, especially now, being really accepted?
Yes, it is, big time. Like, for example, me and Create, as the fourth experience, when we traveled to Germany, to Ibiza, doing festivals of 8,000, 15,000 people, it's...
Humble brag.
I love it.
It's amazing.
We both went from like New York City bars, you understand?
Yeah.
To rock in the best clubs in New York, to be appreciated as a Latino, to go around the world, you know what I mean? To go to Germany, when we were in Germany last year, it was like Germans singing our music that we're playing through our minds and hands with Latino artists.
Love it.
They're Germans. They don't speak English, but they're saying "Dale, dale, gasoli." They're singing the words.
No, that is a great feeling.
It's a feeling
seeing,
that
different people in the world just rocking with that type of music and vibing out with you is that's a beautiful thing.
Yeah,
that just shows you the growth of music and DJing itself. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Latino music is the thing. You know,
yes.
something like J Balvin, Coachella. He killed Coachella.
Right.
You understand? Like, look at that.
He did.
Killed Coachella.
I was there, brother.
Oh, wow.
It was lit.
you
it was crazy. It was lit. His stage production.
Yeah, yeah. No,
next
serious.
Level.
Next
serious.
Level.
Serious.
It was up there with any general market, any crossover artist that's out there
people,
right now.
A lot of people took notes off of that one.
Isn't he also like leading headlining a new festival coming up now? I think I see something.
Absolutely, he's a Lollapalooza.
Yes,
Lollapalooza.
That's what it is.
Lollapalooza.
Yes, that's big.
First time.
First time
a Latino has headlined.
It's taking over.
Yo, we're chilling here, Latin Billboards, Las Vegas, with my family, Kia. Thank you so much for the 2020 Soul. It's beautiful. It's roomy. I love the AC, which I have to turn off now. But yo, we're having a good time. And how did you guys get your start in music? Give me the 411 on that.
You go first.
Well, music was always my thing. I went to college for communication and media relations.
Okay.
While I was in college, I interned at Power 105.1.
Love it.
I had radio. Shout out to them. And then I loved my internship. So after I graduated, I made a fake school letter to stay as an intern at the radio station.
Good job.
Nice.
I stayed there for like a year and a half. I ended up working with Angie Martinez.
All right.
After that, I ended up being like her little assistant, babysitter slash all that fun stuff.
Love it.
And then I had to get a real job because I had real bills to pay.
Yes. And that happens.
So I had to kind of like put music to the side and just get a job and get my life together. And I did that. I saved my money. I bought my new laptop. I bought a controller. And next thing you know, I'm DJing.
Look at you, man.
And I went to school not thinking, like, when I was interning at Power, I never thought that I'd be a DJ. I wanted to be more like a regular radio host.
Right.
But it's crazy how life works, right?
Yes, it does. It's insane. It's very unpredictable.